So we've built three end user based applications anyway. We built the order search and we built our two reports. Now we need to think about how can we deploy these applications to a user. We could send them a link, and there's only three apps, so you could probably send three links out to customers or to your users. But what if you have 300 links or even 30 links? You wouldn't want to send that out to a user. Be too confusing for them. So instead, we recommend utilizing our built-in menuing system. So let me show you how the built-in menuing system works, because once implemented, you only have to give users one link then. Much, much easier for you and for them. So if we go to admin and we go to menu and security, you can see here that, you know, here's where we set up that Rick and that Tyler user. We also have user roles. So if I came over to here, there's kind of a default role, all users. If we had a role name, let's say this is sales, we could call this like the sales roles, it's a nice description. You could do that, and you could also maybe say that there's a CS role for customer service or something like that. So you can have different roles that users can be part of. So if I go back to my application users and I go to Rick, we can say that Rick is part of the customer service role. Could be, you could belong to more than one role as well. And we could say that Tyler is maybe belongs to the sales role. Okay. So users can belong to different roles or multiple roles. And that's important because when we go to assign a menu, you can decide, you can say, hey, this menu should only be seen for CS users or for sales users. So that way you can have customizable roles based on your users. That's really important. The other side of that coin is adding menu groups and menu options. So let's create a menu group, and let's say this major group or this menu group might be data. It's probably not the best name for it, but we'll just call it data. And we'll call the other one, let's call this maintain. And I've already decided that the name data is a terrible name for a menu group. Let's change this to reports. Okay, so we have a reports group and we have a maintain, could maybe call that maintain data group. Okay. Great, so we have two menu groups. So basically all the applications that we're gonna add are gonna belong to one of those two groups, and that's how they'll be organized. So now that we've set all that up, let's go to menu options, and I can add a new menu option. And rather than having to type most of this out, I can go to do a lookup, click retrievals, and click my order search. And that'll populate some of this information here for me, the description and ID and the URL. Now I can give an icon to this. I like adding the icon, a nice graphical piece I think is nice. There's a whole bunch of different icons here that you can use depending on, you know, what you're interested in. And there's really no rhyme or reason for what you pick, just what you think is gonna work best for you. So I'm gonna do the search icon for this guy. And I can say what group I want to have this belong to. So I want to have this belong to the reports group. And I'm going to say that this can be accessible by sales and customer service. So both of my users can access this. So I'll press save. Okay, great. Let's do another one. Let's do our report so we can do order search. And since this is searching, I'll use the binoculars. And again, I'll say this belongs to the reports group. And I can again say sales and CS, or I could just say all users to have it be applicable for everybody. So you could do that as well. Oh, I made a mistake here. Sorry, I picked the wrong, this application already belongs on a menu. So let's go out and go to reports and let's pick the sales drill down. Okay, and that was our second app. Let's do one more app. Let's do our top 10 report. And let's see here, I think we might have, since this is a top 10 type report, let's do the sort icon. And let's say this is for reports, but now let's say this is only for customer service and not for sales. So I will press save on there. Okay, great. So we've got our three applications out there. And let's go out and access this particular menu. So back in Apps, I can click Launch Runtime Menu. So I'm logged on right now as the Tyler user, who I can see two report links available under this Reports tab. If I were to sign off and sign on as the Rick user, now you can see he has three because his user has access to this one extra report.